Donna fans, Jason here, and today we're discussing the Great Fire of New York, aka the burning of New York City in 1776. You see, in the late summer of 1776, the Declaration of Independence had been signed almost 2 months ago, and everyone was excited, well, except the British, who were now coming to take New York City. And although the Patriots did initially put up a fight, it was fairly obvious the British were coming. Suddenly, a fire breaks out in New York City, or should I say, several fires mysteriously break out simultaneously around the city. These fires go up quickly, because everything was made of wood at the time, and burn a quarter of the city. About 1,000 buildings burned down. Now, the Patriots blame the British for this upon their arrival, which is unlikely, because why would they burn a city that they now occupy? They're going to need those buildings, and they want loyalists to flock there and have a place to stay. The British blame the Patriots for burning down the city, which is significantly more likely, though apparently not exactly what happened. You see, the Continental Congress ordered George Washington not to burn down New York City upon his retreat, and though Washington thought this was strategically the best move, he, as we know, generally followed the orders of the Continental Congress. However, many theorize that some enterprising young patriots took it upon themselves to create a little bit of a conspiracy and light some fires around the city. Now, as I said, this wasn't necessarily an uncommon thought. In fact, George Washington was known to say that some enterprising activists did what, quote, "what we cannot do for ourselves," end quote. So Washington, though he did not order this, was excited to see it happen. Either way, the fire burned overnight. It goes out because of a change in wind. Mother Nature decides to put this fire out, which is fortunate for the rest of the residents of New York City and future New York City, because it would take a very long time to rebuild just a quarter of the city, let alone the whole thing. That being said, there's a few reasons the fire was particularly bad. First of all, General Howe, who just got into the city, thought, hey, this certainly seems like a trap. He suspected that Washington did what he wanted to do and burned down the city as a diversion so that they would no longer chase the Continental Army and maybe even get ambushed while they're trying to put it out. So therefore, he waits a particularly long time before sending anyone to extinguish the blaze. Additionally, we're talking about the 18th century here. They didn't have fire departments. They didn't even have hoses. They had really two strategies. One was to knock down buildings so that the fire wouldn't have another building next door to catch on fire. And the other one was buckets. They would just go to the water, fill up a bucket, pass it up the line, throw it on the fire. But when you have 1,000 buildings on fire, buckets aren't necessarily going to do the trick. So New York City at large was fortunate that, as I said, Mother Nature put this one out with the changing of the winds. After this, well, General Howe goes through arresting people, assuming that they had set this fire ablaze. And although he arrests hundreds of people, no one's ever actually charged with the crime. And therefore, the greatest fire in New York history is still a mystery. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, hit like. If you're new here, do me a favor and subscribe for a new video 7 days a week. And I'll be back with another founder for you tomorrow.